distinction between Nirodha Samadhi, Asampradnata Samadhi and sleep is being drawn. Nirodha Samadhi is Sarvadhi Vritti Rahita. Sushupti also is Sarvadhi Vritti Rahita, free from all the vrittis. Therefore, one should not mistake the Nirodha Samadhi to be the same as sleep. If that were the case, why such a so much of efforts and all that? You want to learn and learn a text is so much difficult. Practice will happen. So it is not that way. So one should not doubt that both are identical. Why? Visheshat. Vishesha is distinction. Because there is distinction between these two, Nirodha Samadhi and Sri Shukti. How the distinction is there? Manasvarupa sadasattvabhyam. Sattva, asattva. Sattva is presence. Asattva is absence. Now what is this manasvarupa? We should understand properly. Because of presence and absence of manasvarupa, there is distinction between sleep and Nirodha Samadhi. The question arises, where is the Manasvarupa Sattva presence is there? Where is the Manasvarupa Asattva absence is there? That should be seen. Now what is this Manasattva? Manasattva can be taken as the usual functions of the mind. Usual function of the mind. Mentation. Now, in Nirodha Samadhi, mentation is there, Manasattva is not, why is not there? Manonasha is accomplished. Now be careful here about this word Manonasha. Manonasha doesn't mean the antakarana, chitta, the mana is totally extinct. Manonasha me, the usual functions, activities of the mind are stopped. It is otherwise called as vritti rahitya. Vritti rahitya. Is it not accomplished? So therefore, if you say manaswarupa, manaswarupa as the meditations, that is asat absence where in the Nirodha Samadhi, therefore Manaswarupa not present in where the Nirodha Samadhi, in the sense Manonasha has been accomplished. Be careful about this word Manonasha, because it gives an idea, or that means notion, mind is what? Destroyed. Mind can get destroyed only in Videha Mukti. In death also it is not destroyed. Sukshma Sharira travels. So, even in the case of Jivan Mukti also, even if the person is totally lost in Nirodha Samadhi, already told, samskaras are there. Chittena nirvignam atma anubhuyate. In the earlier Veda, what happens in the Nirodha Samadhi? By chittena, what chitta it is? Not this usual prank, mind which has got usual prank. Which it is samskarataha, some samskara is there. So with that, the chittena, it can be nirvignam atma anubhuyate. Sleep. Manasvarupa. Present or absent? Absent. See, look, mana is absent for the time being there. Where is it gone? It has merged in its cause this, but Manonasha has not taken place, because this mind is waiting to surface again once the sleep prarabdha is over. Once the sleep prarabdha is over, the mind is going to come either in the waking or the dream. The mind is intact, unscathed. It is exactly as it was earlier. Manonasha is not accomplished, but mind is not destroyed. In sleep, mind is not present. Why mind is not present? Not that you have accomplished Manonasha or you have got Videha Mukti, not that way. It is in the seed form, dormant form, there in the Ajnana. That is why, then, that Antakarna, mind, is related to this individual. Otherwise, what will happen, you know? The movement wakes up. Who am I? Not Vedantic inquiry. Who am I? Where am I? Nobody will dare to sleep. You know why? Mera's bank balance kya ho jayega? By so much of efforts I have earned this property and all this. So movement is saying he doesn't know who he is. Nobody will dare to sleep. It is intact. So therefore, Manaswarupa is present in Nidra. Though mind temporarily is not there. Mind is on the privileged leave. So it is sleeping. It is sleeping. So that is that. So therefore, this is the Vishesha. So the Manonasha is present in Nirodha Samadhi. Doesn't mean mana is destroyed. The usual mentations are stopped. Vritti Rahitya. See, that is how even a Jivan Mukta, where he is out of the samadhi, he is able to deal with the world. Vyavahara is possible. That's why we say that mind is, that chitta is badhita. Like effort, rote to be over, but no capacity to mind. That will be very disharm. Now this disharm, drawn, described by our Vendra, that is the Aunt Kareka. Adhukam tadi, ye vashaya, distinction between the sea and the samadhi, is upam, described, rupodhaya, ila, ngayara. Of dying vidruha, which has the sat pandadas, and is nirvil sivaha, sivaha, viveka. Viveka, what is that viveka? There in Mandukya Karaka it is said, atma satyanu bodhaha. What is atma satyanu bodhaha? Atma eva satyam. Baki sab mithya. So that is what is atma satyanu bodhaha, that dhimataha. One who is endowed with this knowledge, viveka means this knowledge, atma alone is satyam which he has directly recognized, and that mind which is nirvikalpaha nirvikalpasya. So it's of such a mind, see, mind is there. The mind which is in Nirodha Samadhi, Nirvikalpa, and Dhiman, means having the Atma Satyanu Buddha, is Atma Jnana. It's add there, Yaha Pracharaha. See, Yaha Pracharaha. See, what is Prachara? Here, Prachara is not our usual Prachara, Vyapara. Vyapara means occupation. So, get the occupation. What is that occupation? Getting absorbed in Atma Swarupa. Sahatu. And Yogi Bhi Vidneyaha. Sahatu Yogi Bhi Vidneyaha. Literally, it should be known by Yogi means it can be known only by Yogi. Not that it must be known by Yogi, in the sense it can be known only by yogi. A yogi can't know it. So therefore, yogi bhi vidneyaha. So vidneyaha. And it is, see, sushuptyanna, the sushupte, that is the correct reading, yes. Or sushuptanyaha. Or sushupte anyaha ad pracharaha na tat samaha. Sushupte anyaha pracharaha. The vyapara in the sushupti is anyaha. Anyaha means distinct from niruddha avastha. Distinct from nirodha samadhi. How do you say so? It is explained. He, this distinction is so because he, sushuptau, in the sleep, add there, manaha karana rupayam avidyayam, continue, liyati. Distinction is so because in sleep, sushuptau, add manaha, the mind, what does it do? Karana rupayam avidyayam, this much is adhyara. In the avidya, which is its cause, what happens? Liyate, gets merged, gets dissolved, means the effect, the sleep is not there. What is there only? Avidya only is there. Means not sleep, mind. In sleep, we are talking of in sleep. In sleep, mind is not there. Mind is not functioning in terms of vrittis. So therefore, what is mind? Sankalpa, vikalpa, atmakam. All sankalpa, vikalpa, vrittis have stopped now. So dhriyate, whereas tat means that manaha, nigrihitam, when in the Nirodha Samadhi, it says, naliyate, is not absorbed, means mind is verily present in the, this, samskarata, that is the samskarata is there. Tadeva nirbhayam brahma. See, verily then, when nigrihita mana is there, Nirodha Samadhi accident, what is there is only nirbhayam brahma. So, hai samantataha, that is sarvavyapakaha jnana lokam. At that time, what is there is jnana lokam, vijnanaika rasa. Jnana, vidjnana is rasa ghanam. Aloka means prakasha. Jnana prakasha. What jnana prakasha? The chaitanya and chaitanya alone, which is rasa ghana, which is nothing but paramananda swarupa. Samantataha means sarva vyapakam, all pervasive that is there. When that is there, come on. Only a lip service? What is there? Only Atma is there. All that is to present us the duality and the prapancha is not there. And Atma being Anubhava Swarupa, what is it? Is it short of Anubhava? It is itself is Anubhava without the Triputis. Without the Triputis. So further it is said in the Mandukya, in the Karikas. There is also in Andashram, in the bracket they have given, Mandukya Shakhayam Api Shruyate. It is not necessary because this is not Mandukya Shakha. It is not original Upanishad. It is Karika. Ubhayoho Pradnya Turyayoho. Sixth case dual of these both. Pradnya and Turiya. Who is Pradnya? The sleeper consciousness in the sense, the Chaitanya Atma identified with the causal body, Karana Sharira, Pradnya. And Turiya, the state of fourth state in the sense, wherein Vishwa, Taijasa, Pradnya with all Adhyastha Prapancha is absent. It is a state of Kevala Atma Swarupa. Turiya Yoho of these two, Dvaitasya Agrahanam Tulyam. Dvaitasya Agrahanam. Agrahanam Tulyam. So Dvaitasya Agrahanam. Dvaitasya Agrahanam means the non-cognition of the Dvaita Rupa. Dvaita Rupa Jagat. It should be taken this way. Ubhayoho, before Ubhayoho, add Yadyapi. Before Ubhayoho, add Yadyapi. Yadyapi Ubhayoho Pradnyaturyayoho Dvaitasya Agrahanam. So Dvaitasya Agrahanam. What is that Dvaita? Anyatha Agrahanam. This is, Gaudapadacharya is very fond of these words. Agrahana, Anyatha Agrahana. Agrahana is non-apprehension, non-cognition. Anyatha Agrahana is misapprehension. Misapprehension. So that Dvaita is always which is Anyatha Grahita. So which is erroneously cognized as such. Of that Dvaitasya, Agrahanam, no cognition, non-apprehension, he says, Agrahanam, Tulyam, Tulyam, then add, Tathapi, me, see, in deep sleep state and in Turiya state is this only, Nirodhavastha only, in both, the Dvaita Jagat is not cognized. Therefore, you can't equate both these as the same. You can't. Tathapi, yadya. So, therefore, tathapi, even them, pradnyaha, bija nidra yutaha. Remember, distinction between Nirodh Samadhi and sleep is being drawn now. Pradnyaha, the sleeper, means one who is endowed with sleep, the individual who is endowed with sleep, bija nidra yutaha. Is endowed with, yutaha, endowed with, the bija, endowed with nidra. What is nidra? Agrahanam. Nidra is agrahanam, you don't get it. Which is bija for anyatha agrahanam. Endowed with nidra, sleep, which is non-apprehension, which is the cause for bija, for misapprehension. So misapprehension. That is, nidra means ajnana, ignorance. Ajnana, which is the bija, the cause for anyathagrahana, misapprehension. This is where in pradnya means in sleep, one who is endowed sleep. whereas Sacha, that Bija Nidra, Sa stands for Bija Nidra, Turiye, in Turiya, the fourth state means in the Nirodha Samadhi, says Na Vidyate, simple. In Turiyavastha, Ajnana is not there. In sleep, what is there? Ajnana is there. That is the distinction. Adyau. Who is Adyau? The first two. Vishvatayajasau. See Tika. Below the stanza, the Tika is there. So Vishvatayajasau. The first two. Because they are in this order. Vishva, Taijasa, Pradnya and Turiya. Who is Vishva? Atma identified with the waking upadhi and that what is called waker consciousness. All these you are supposed to know. This you are jivat, we are doing jivan mukti viveka. Anyway, who is Taijasa? Dreamer consciousness. The Chaitanya Atma and identified with the subtle body and the dream. Pradnya we have seen, Turiya we have seen. So there we say, Adyau, Vishva Taijasau, we say Vishva and Taijasau, Adarino, Adyau, Swapna Nidra Yutau. They are endowed with Swapna and Nidra. What is Swapna? Anyatha, Grahanam, and this Nidra is Agrahana, Abodha, Ajnana. Means in Swapna what is there? In Vishva and Taijasa, both non-apprehension is there and also misapprehension is there. See, you don't know Vastu, Brahma is Brahma, you are seeing either the waking world or the dream world. And for both what is required? Ajnana is required. This is common. Bijanyade. Swapna Nidrayatav. Whereas to show the distinction, Prajnyaha Aswapna Nidraya. So Prajna is how? Aswapna Nidraya. Swapna Rahita Nidraya. And you know what is this Swapna? Don't take only dream, waking also. Because Gaudapada Acharya clubs waking and dream as Swapna. He doesn't consider the waking separately. Do you know why? Anyatha Grahanam is common. Misapprehension is common to the waking and the dream. So therefore he clubs straight away. Your waking also is from the Atma Swarupa standpoint is a dream only. So therefore he doesn't distinguish between, he doesn't club these two. He doesn't take separately the waking and the dream in this context. So therefore say, so Swapna, tu prajnyaha aswapna nidraya. So aswapna nidraya bhavati. So that he is with the vidura. Now he says, whereas nishchitaha brahmavidaha, those who have got brahma jnana, turiye, in the turiyavastha, in the nirodhavastha, na nidram naivacha swapnam pashyanti. So there, swapna, tu prajnyaha swapna nidraya, add there, yutaha, endowed, that's all. Swapna nidraya and yutaha. Whereas in the nishchitaha brahma jnaninaha brahma vidaha turiye, in the turiya state, na nidram pashyanti naivacha swapnam pashyanti. They don't experience nidra or the swapna. So that is, means they don't have neither the misapprehension nor the non-apprehension, because they directly are able to apprehend or comprehend, know the Atma Swarupa. Continuing. Tattvam anyata grinnataha sapnaha ad bhavati. Tattvam anyata grinnataha sapnam bhavati. What is this anyata grahana? Tika itself explains. See the tika. Advaitasya vastunaha anyatagrahanam nama. The anyatagrahana means the misapprehension of advaita vastu atma nama, whatever that is called, is, you know what is it? Dvaita rupena pratibhasaha. Appearance, experience in the form of dualistic world. Vaita rupena pratibhasaha, the appearance or experience in the form of dualistic world, vaita rupa prapancha, that is anyatagrana. So therefore, tattvam ajantaha means in the case of a person who doesn't know the atma tattva, who is ajnani, so what happens? And who is anyatagrinataha, one who sees the duality, you see, Swapnaha bhavati. So what he is experiencing is swapna. See here, he has included waking also. Because dvaita is experienced both in the waking and the dream. So swapnaha bhavati. Swapna bhavati. Whereas, again, tattvam. Again, you take this way. So you take this. Tattvam anyatha grinnataha. Ajanata comes now. We have already taken. Tattvam anyatha grinnataha swapnaha bhavati. Take again tattvam. Tattvam ajanataha nidra bhavati. For a person who doesn't know tattva means only non-apprehension is there. What is not there? Anyatha grahana dvaita pratiti is not there. Cognition of dualistic world, either the waking and dream, is there. For that person, tattvam ajanataha. So what is not there? The nidra bhavati. What is experiencing is sleep. So, tayoho, of those two, what are those? Swapna nidrayoho, of swapna nidrayoho, viparyase, khine. Tayoho, of swapna nidrayoho, viparyasa kshine, when the viparyasa is destroyed, kshine destroyed. What is viparyasa? Mithyajnana, in the sense, tattvagrahana and viparita jnana. See, viparyasa means topsy-turvy, means something other than what it is. See, you are not knowing also something other than what it is. Misapprehending also is something other than what it is. So therefore, anyatagrahana and agrahana, both clubbed together, he has used the word viparyasa. Viparyasa means something viparita, ulta. Not knowing also is ulta, wrongly knowing also is ulta. So that is what is there. Viparyasa means mithyajnana, in the sense, both. Of the words from this which you have already seen, the first two sentences we have already seen of Tika. Then Sahacha Vishvataya. So सहाच विश्वतैजसयो हो वर्तमानः स्वप्नः इति उच्यते. व्हाट इज दैट सहा? द्वैत रूपेण प्रतिभासः. आई होप यू आर, आई एम टॉकिंग टीका नाउ. इन टीका फर्स्ट आद्य विश्वतैजसो एंड नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस आई हैव टेकन. अद्वैतस्य वस्तुनः अन्यथा ग्रहणम नाम द्वैत रूपेण प्रतिभासः. अन्यथा ग्रहण इज द्वैत रूपेण प्रतिभास. प्रतिभासः सहा. सहा मीन्स दैट appearance or experience in terms of dvaita rupa jagat. Where is it? Vishvataijasayoho vartamanaha. It is found where? In the Vishva and Taijasa. It is called Swapna. With this definition, do you know what is that? What it means? Waking also is clubbed in the Swapna, because in waking also you are experiencing the dvaita pratibhasa, dvaita rupin pratibhasa. Then what is Nidra? Tattvasya adhyanam. We have seen this. Tattvasya adhyanam. Ignorance of one's own swarupa is nidra. Where is it found? Sacha means that nidra. Vishva taijasa taijasa pradneshu vartate. All three. Nidra is, see, now you are in nidra. I don't mean you are sleeping. So you have ignorance. Unless ekdam nirodh samadhi kal ho gayi. Theek hai. So sacha sa nidra. And what is the nidra? Tattvasya adhyanam. Vishwa, waker consciousness. Taijasa, the dreamer consciousness. Pradnya, the sleeper consciousness. Vartate. So therefore is a continuing. विपर्यास वर्ब विपर्यासे तयोक्षेणे तुरीयं पदम अश्नुते. इवन कोटेशंस ऑल्सो ही इज एक्सप्लेनिंग. दैट इज व्हाट विद्यारण्य मुनि. तयो हो, सो द सिक्स्थ केस ड्यूअल. हूज स्वप्न निद्रयो हो. Of this Swapna and Nidra, see, so the Swarupa Bhuta Yoho, who in reality are Atma only. Whether it is Swapna or Nidra, what is Swapna? Dvaita Rupena Pratibhasa. What is Nidra? Tattvasya Adhyana. What is the Swarupa of that? The basis for that? Atma only. In reality, who are Atma only. Viparyasa, what is the viparyasa? Ulta, ulti khopadi, mithyadnyanam. It is what? Mithyadnyanam. Mithyadnyanam means the something other than what it is. Wrong knowledge, wrong notion. See, not knowing also is wrong, other than what it is. Taking it to be dvaita also is other than what it is. That is the viparyasa, ulta. Tasmin vidyaya kshine sati. Tasmin means that viparyase, when this mithyadnyana, which is both dvaita pratibhasa and adhyana, both when vidyaya kshine, by atmadhyana, when it is destroyed, kshine sati, Turiyam padam advaitam vastu ashnute. Turiyam padam. What is turiyam padam? Advaitam vastu. The non-dual Brahma is ashnute. Ashnute means it is experienced. Prapnoti. It is gained. Ashnute ha. In your book is there. That is his alternate is there. Ashnute. The meaning is given as anubhavati. Anubhavati. In here it is Ashnute only is there, but in Tippani another reading is given. The meaning is Anubhavati. So in this way, what is it? There is distinction between sleep and asampradnyat samadhi, nirodha samadhi. And for Jivan Mukti, What is required? Nirodha Samadhi required. Why Nirodha Samadhi is required? To get freed from chitta, klesha, all these meditation. Sir, for a person who wants to gain knowledge, he has to get Nirodha Samadhi, I accept. Once that knowledge is gained, for Jivan Mukti, why do you need Nirodha Samadhi? All that you want to have is cessation of chitta klesha, no? Without effort possible. What? Sleep. This is Purapaksha. This is Purapaksha is coming now. See, look, why for gaining knowledge Nirodha Samadhi is required, because otherwise you will not directly cognize the Atma Swarupa. Once Jnana ho gaya, baad mein chutti karo. All, and you have to, no, this chitta klesha tormenting, sleep will remove that. Why? So let us see now. Didrukshoho. Okay. He says, sir, look here. Astu evam, in this manner, you see, with great pains you have distinguished between Sushupti and Asampradnya Samadhi. See? Astu evam Asampradnyata Samadhi Sushuptyoho. Between these two, Mahan Bhedaha. Total distinction. Total different. Accepted. That's it. And Tatra, in this, between these two, means Sushupti and Nirodha Samadhi. Tatva Didrikshoho means for a Jidnyasu. One who is desirous of gaining the knowledge, seeing the tattva, one who wants to have the sakshatkara of Atma Sarupa. For such a tattva didrikshu, see, darshana sadhanatvena, as a means of darshana, direct cognition, sakshatkara, samadhi apekshayam api, even though Nirodha Samadhi is necessary, I accept that. Even though it is necessary, he says, drishta tattvasya. For a person who has already got this Atma Sakshatkara, and he is who now? Drishta Tattvaha. Who is Drishta Tattvaha? Jnani. For a Jnani, Jivan Muktai, to have the Jivan Mukti, tadapeksha nasti. What apeksha nasti? Nirodha Samadhehe Asampradnyata Samadhehe apeksha nasti. Not aware. Why you are telling, recommending to get rid of the chitta klesha, no? Look, chitta klesha can be easily terminated. How? Without samadhi. Raga dveshadi klesha bandhasya. The chitta klesha, raga, dvesha, adi, all kama, krodha, lobha, moha, which is we said bandharupa in the beginning. Jivan Mukti definition while giving. You are told, no? Chitta klesha, that klesha bandhasya, sushuptya api nivruttehi. It can be removed by what? Even by sleep. So why again this what? Take, what is that? Vidvat sannyasa and then take to Nirodha Samadhi appraise. Why all these things? Say, sir, don't say maevam. Don't say. Why? You are talking of sleep. Which sleep you are talking? Are you talking daily sleep? Which comes in cycle? Are you talking? Night, 11 o'clock. So, what are you talking of that sleep? Or you have to put forth special efforts to get additional sleep to get rid of the chitta klesha? He analyzes. Kim pratidinam? Ask question. Finds out what this fellow has got in the mind as such. He says, look, are you talking of pratidinam svataha prapta kada chitki sushupti? means natural sleep that comes in cycle every day. Are you talking of that which will remove the chitta, klesha, ragade, etc.? That is one. So that is that. Pratidinam svataha prapta, every day which comes naturally, kadachitki, not all the time, at times, night time, etc. Daytime also person is very much tired, etc. It can come as such. Afternoon, sumptuous food, lunch is over, so you feel drowsy. At times it comes. Do you speak of that? Sushupti, sushupti, bandha nivartika, raga desha diklesha bandha, it removes. Do you speak that? Or other possibility, va abhyasena nirantaravartini. You have, see, so much of practice was given for nirodha abhyasa. Now, separate abhyasa, practice to have a continuously. Even Kumbhakarna will fail because he has to get up after 6 months. So therefore, are you talking of a continuous sleep accomplished by special efforts? So are you talking of that will remove the what? Raga dvesha diklesha bandha. See, that is there. That is two questions are there. Even in first question, there is other sub-questions are there. So what is that? Adyapi. Adyapi means what? In the natural sleep which comes at times, you see, kim by sleep, sushupti kalinasya klesha bandhasya nivritti kimba kalantara vartina klesha bandhasya nivritti. See, you are talking, sleep is what? Removing the bandharupa afflictions in terms of raga dvesha. Are you talking that natural sleep removes the ragadi klesha bandha at the period of, during the duration of the sleep? Or kalantara vartini, see, you slept for 8 hours and that day, rest of the 16 hours, chigragadi klesha bandha gone. Do you mean to say that? Kalantara vartini means what? The chitta ragadi klesha bandha for the period other than the duration of the sleep. In the duration of the sleep, it goes, everyone accepts. But that sleep, will it remove other thing also? He says, Nimartiki, yes. Kalavatnaha, he says, na adhyaha. See, it is na adhyaha, not the first possibility. What is that? Aprasaktehe. What is the first possibility? Natural sleep. What is that? It removes the ragadi klesha bandha. It says no. So why? Aprasaktehe. Aprasaktehe means it doesn't apply, it is inapplicable. Sir, you are talking something irrelevant. You are talking something which is not applicable, irrelevant. Why, how it is irrelevant? You say, Mudhanam api sushuptau klesha bandaha nahi. If you say, by sleep, in the case of Jivan Mukta, Jnani, this klesha bandha goes, even for Mudha means who? Ajnani also, in actual natural sleep, what is that? Klesha bandha is not there. Where is the question of that? So that means, I hope you understood. See, if you say, in sleep, klesha bandha is not there for whom? Jnani, context jnani, that is equally applicable to who? Mudha, it's irrelevant thing you are talking. So therefore, that is not true. That is mudhanapavi sushuptau klesha bandha. Otherwise, what will happen? Anyasa, anyatha, ayasaha, prasajyeta. See, if klesha bandha, see, even for ajnani, So if in sleep klesha bandha is not there, do you know then what will happen? So there will be ayasa, reluctance for everyone to go to sleep. Because why? In sleep what is that? All klesha bandha or turmoil continues. No, even for ajnani also there is no this thing, shanti, shanti, shanti in the sleep. So therefore, anyatha. Where is that? Anyatha ayasa prajajata. Anyatha means if in the case of ajnani, in sleep, raga dvesha adi klesha bandha afflictions were there, then there will be reluctance to go to sleep. Reluctance to go to sleep, prasajita. Now, na dvitiyaha means you sleep and that sleep removes the raga adi klesha bandha in the rest of the period. What is the rest of the period? Waking and the dream. He says na dvitiyaha, not true. Why? Asambhava, it is not possible. Why? It is very well known. Nahi annak anya kali naya shuktya kalantara vartinaha kleshasya kshayaha sambhavati. Means, by a sleep in a given period of time, the klesha bandha of other period is not removed. I hope you understood this. See, sleeping for a particular duration will not remove your raga adibandha klesha of the remaining period, like waking and the dream. It's not possible. So aprasak, that is what? Not with asambhava, it is impossible. Same thing is explained. How it is impossible? Nahi anna kali naya sushuktya. Means by a sleep in a specific period of time, kalantara vartinaha klesha sakshayaha. The klesha which is there in the other period. What is the other period? Waking and the dream? No. It is not possible. Kshayaha na sambhavati. Suppose, if that were to take place, do you know what will happen? This is applicable to even this ajnani also. You need not be jnani for that. Mudha anyatha. Anyatha means, if the sleep in a given period were capable of removing the raga, this klesha bandha, the affliction, then what will happen? Even for ajnani, one sleeps, what happens? Yeah. Straight away jivan mukti, you don't need a tattva. You are talking after tattva jnana. Even tattva jnana also is not required. All that is there, you are asleep. And you need not do anything at all. By birth the fellow goes and then bala will be greater jivan mukta. So that is there. So it is not so. Kalantara anyatha mudhanamapi. Even the case of ajnanis, jagarana sapna yoho, both in the waking and the dream, what will happen? Kleshasya kshayaha prasajyeta. That means the termination of affliction will take place, which is not true. So therefore, first question is answered. It means first possibility is refuted. The second possibility, what is that? So no, I don't speak of natural sleep, special sleep. What is a special sleep? Continuous sleep. How it can be? By special effort. Now, if you can... If Nirodha Samadhi can be accomplished by special effort, so like that some special effort you have to do. Otherwise you will start a project of research. Research. How to sleep continuously so that Ragadi Klesha Bandha will not be there. See, that's this is that. Means if you are talking that by special effort, continuous and consistent sleep is accomplished, and therefore what will happen? Ragadi, Chitta, Klesha, Bandha will go, and this Tattva Jnani need not practice Nirodha Samadhi, if that is the case. Napi Sushuptau Nairantaryam Abhyasitum Shakyam. See? If our sushupti, nairantarya means continuity, means it is not possible to practice something to have the continuous and consistent sleep. Impossible. It is not possible. Sakyam. Why? Because the reason is given. Tasyaha. Tasyaha means sushuptehe of that sleep. You know how this sleep is programmed? Karma kshaya nimittatva. So karma kshaya. What karma kshaya? In terms of prarabdha, the waking prarabdha and dream prarabdha is over. What happens? The sleep comes. And once that prarabdha of sleep is over, the fellow is again thrown back in the either waking or the dream. So therefore, so exhaustion of karma phala giving waking and dream is the cause of sleep. Karma shraya nimittatva. So that should be, then only sleep comes, otherwise not. So tasma, therefore, tatva vidaha api, for even the jnani who is still not a jivan mukta, not tatva vidhi, is not jivan mukta. So the one simple jnani, who is simple jnani? One who has got jnana, but still that sthairya is not there, that the continuity in the samadhi is not there. So still that other thing, manonasha, the vasanakshaya, etc. are throwing him out in the earlier experience only. So therefore, tattvavidhapi, kleshakshayaya, the raga dveshadi, chitta, klesha bandha kshayaya, bandha, astyeva, certainly, what is there? Asampradnyata samadhi, apeksha, expectation means, necessity of the asampradnyata samadhi, nirodha samadhi. And see all these, you know from where it started? We have forgotten the beginning point. Shanai ruparami buddhya dhriti grihitaya atma samstammana kritva. Nakinchidapi chintaye. Here, I think 67th page or somewhere it has started. And in that context, while explaining shanaihi, he brought the four stages. Yachenvang manasi prajnaha, vag bhumi, mano bhumi, jnanatma bhumi, mahanatma bhumi, to be finally merged where in the shantatma. Or for that, for Shantatma, this what was required was Nirodha Abhyasas, a practice of Asampradnyata Samadhi. He now summarizes because he has to Shanai, Upar, he has to go to Uparamet, Buddhya Dhriti Grihitaya. Still this to be continued. See, one Gita stanza, of course, because the context is Yoga Samadhi, Jivan Mukti. And for Jivan Mukti, what is required? Nirodha Samadhi required. So he has to. And that Shanai, what is that? Bhashyakara can't take this. If Bhashyakara were to explain like this, 100 times Bhashya will be there. He will be defying the principles of the writing Bhashya. That is why. So that is the other, like Prakarana Grantha. That is the job of the Prakarana Grantha. That is the purpose of Prakarana Grantha. Because Shastra, Bhashya comes under the category of Shastra. Shastra has got to say, Shastra only wants to establish the this thing. It has no leisure to take care or the token to account the personal problems of the sadhakas. What are the sadhanas? The sadhanas also will be hinted. Samadhi shuddhanta karanena. Bas ho gaya. Ye sab a gaya udhar. Samadhi shuddhanta karanena. So, it's the job of the one who writes the Prakarana Granthas to explain. You know that? Rishikesh side, there is a story among sadhu circles. There were two guys. One was Veda, other was Acharya. Mr. Veda and Mr. Acharya. Always these used to go together. And this Mr. Veda used to make a statement, a very pithy statement. You can't understand afterward, the Mr. Acharya used to explain. Once Mr. Veda said, newly born lamb ate the tender leaves of a huge banyan tree from the branch, not the cut and kicked. Newly born lamb ate the tender leaves of the top branch of a huge banyan tree on the branch. Veda made the remark. What did you understand? How a newly born lamb can climb on, not that it is cut and the ground, no, climb on the top of the banyan tree eat on the branch. How is that? Now it is the job of Acharya. He said, there was a dry, deep well. And in the well, a banyan tree had grown, and the top branch came on the ground, and this lamb ate it. Understood? That is what it is. So that is how. So a Bhashyakara has proved. See, even what Gita has said, if Bhashya was not, we can't understand. He has explained. But further, this thing and for Jivan Mukti, we want someone else to teach us. So like that, it is that way as such. So therefore, you see, Bhashyakara can't go on in this thing. Shanai, Shanai, Uparamit, all this, you see, you count the pages in your Ramakrishna Bhishma. Here it is 67 somewhere, and we have come to 81 page here. And in that, it will be still more as such. So fine. So therefore, now he summarizes. Because too much of this is summarizes so that he can proceed further. The four bhumis. Of that samadhi, the first bhumi, what is that? Vang nirodha. Yachedvang manasi pradnyaha. So that. Tasya samadhi. What samadhi? Nirodha samadhi, asampradya samadhi. Says samadhi. Gavadishu. Here little difference. Means as in the case of, this it was given. Gavadishu yuva. Here gavadishu. In your book it is gav ashvadishu yuva. Like the cow, horses, how they are mute. Like that, what should be there? Vang nirodha. One should control the speech. It is upalakshana for all indriya nigraha. Prathama bhumi. This is the first stage. Then, second one is, see, bala mudha dishiva. Like the bala, a child. Mudha here is a fool. Like them, nirmanastvam. Nirmanastvam means mindlessness, thoughtlessness, not being occupied in a specific thought, which is the usual, means the usual functions of the mind are controlled. Just, that's all. For that, you just find out what your mind does first, how it runs here and there. Simply that is, just simply is there. So that means the usual specific thoughts are not there, it's just like that. That is the second nirmanasvam, ditiya bhumihi. Then the third bhumi. So tandrayam iva, as in the case of drowsiness, ahankara rahitya. Which ahankara? Vishesha ahankara rahitya. So because in Tandri, Samanya Ahankara is there. So that Vishesha Ahankara, absence of the specific, that individualistic I-ness, ego, is not there. That is the Tritiya Bhumi. The fourth one. As in the sleep, the absence of Mahatattva. What is Mahatattva? Mahanatma. Who is that? Samanya Ahankara. So that is the fourth stage. That is now. See, he has concluded now. See? Upakrama, explain upasamhara. So that with respect to these four stages, tadetad bhumi chatushtayam abhipretya, keeping in this view. So what was told? Shanaihi shanaihi, in stages, gradually, by degrees, uparamed iti uktam. One should withdraw the mind so that finally it can be made to get absorbed in the shanta atma. That is what is told. So now, shanai shanai ruparamed. How? Buddhya dhriti grihitaya. Okay, shanaihi shanaihi, over. Now, dhriti grihitaya buddhya. This phrase he is going to thrash. Siddhartha says, see, that is that. Atracha uparame dhriti grihita buddhi sadhanam. So, uparama has to be done. What is the means? Continue. Atracha. Atracha means in the uparama. Atracha uparame means up in these four stages. Four stages are what? Gradually you have to take to high. Directly it is, in the suddenly it is not possible. So therefore uparame, he said, dhriti grihita buddhi sadhanam. So what is sadhanam? Buddhi which is dhairena yukta. Yukta means by courage. Of course he gives a different meanings for that. But just dhriti grihita buddhi.
Good.